When it comes to network communication models like the Open Systems Interconnection and the TCP/IP models, encapsulation plays a very important part. These models are constructs that are used to describe and understand network communications. Encapsulation, however, is the process through which the original data being sent is separated into portions and passed down the protocol stack until it becomes bits that can be sent on the medium. At each layer, specific headers and sometimes trailers are added to the data to provide the necessary information for that layer's function. For example, the transport layer adds port numbers, the network layer adds IP addresses, and the data link layer adds MAC addresses and frame information. Each layer treats everything above it as just data, or simply as the payload. And that's the great thing about these layered models. Each layer only cares about the processes involved within it. It doesn't concern itself with what's happening in the layer above or the layer below. This is called abstraction. By keeping the responsibilities of each layer separate, protocols can be developed, improved, or replaced independently, as long as they respect the interface between layers. So when the encapsulation process reaches the physical medium, all of those headers, along with the original data, is simply a stream of bits ready to be transmitted over the medium. On the receiving end, the process is reversed. Each layer reads and removes its respective header, and this is called decapsulation, and it interprets the information and passes the remaining data up the stack. Encapsulation ensures that data is properly prepared, transmitted, and interpreted between devices, making modern networking possible. For more telecom and networking simply explained, simply subscribe.